Welcome back to another episode here in our Chicago Bears online user franchise. It's about to be week two, going up against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. A very close win by us in week one against the Green Bay Packers. And obviously Tampa here is 0-1. Didn't see the level of loss they had. It might have just been a close game. I don't know. But it's another team that's kind of in a rebuild type mode. If you're new to the series, maybe you don't know that we've made some trades already. We have tried to fix up the team a little bit. O-line offense, everything's pretty much the same, but we did trade off Claypool in our return for Uche. We also do have Boogie Basham now at right end, and that's kind of it. So far, though, I will say the linebackers outside of Edmonds have been a bit rough to work with, as, of course, they're a bit slower on the outside. So guys like Jeremy Banks and then Nizruldeen, you know, maybe Jeremy Banks at least takes the job for Noah Sewell, but we'll give him another chance, as Sewell is, you know, a decent draft pick for this team, and he's got potential. But I will say Jeremy Banks, with that speed and excel and change of direction even, looks very promising. Great hit power as well. Very raw, but which one of these players isn't, you know, that are slower? Mr. Sewell. So, I don't know. We'll see. We'll obviously keep an eye on that. This is where it would have been nice in the preseason, but preseason was canceled, so on account of rain. But let's take a look at the depth chart of the Buccaneers real quick. Maybe he made a trade. I don't know. So I want to pay attention to that. Kyle Trask is apparently the starter. Rashad White is the starting running back. Wide receivers are going to be those, usual suspects, if you will. Don't know why Trey Palmer isn't his number three. Kate Otten, very tall, but not very fast. Left tackle's amazing. Left guard's okay. Center's amazing. Right guard's okay. Right tackle's terrible. Left end's decent with, obviously, very good speed, but he's going to take a while to develop. Right end's okay. Vita Vea is amazing. Shaquille Barrett's definitely good enough, especially since he's a superstar. Middle linebackers are great. Right out's okay. Corners are pretty decent, but there's a little bit of lacking of speed, especially like CB2. Free safety's pretty good, but he's shorter. And then right strong safety's really fast and tall. And his zone coverage is through the roof. How the hell is he so good? Looking at the abilities in this one, Levante David with Lurker, Deflator, and Mid-Zone KO, which is insane. Double me, deep out elite, red zone elite, and mid in elite for Mike Evans, which is also great. Turned into freaking old man McGee. Skill protector is great. Natural talent is pretty decent. El Toro and buy one, get one free. At least it's not inside zone or inside stuff. We already know about DJ Moore. Secure protector and all day. He was insane for the center. Chris Godwin is very good with slot-o-matic and mid in elite. We'll see if he actually puts him in the slot. And then Shaquille Barrett has edge threat as like a 12 overall. Like, that's just brutal, dude. Like, I don't even know what else to tell you. That's just some pain. We actually can see both of our uniforms. What is this? Like some mad update? When did this come out? And here it is in Tampa Bay, Florida. I don't even know if it's Tampa Bay, but Tampa, Florida. For this matchup of two mids trying to make a good. Does two mids make an average? I don't know, but we're going to see when we kick it off deep. Hopefully we have ourselves a good fun one. And let's try to stay healthy. Let's try to stay healthy, have some games that maybe, some plays for some players that maybe get some breakout chances, because we really need breakouts for a lot of players here. Gonna be running a little bit of a blitz. That Gordon going against Evans. I mean, luckily for us, he doesn't really have the speed, but I don't think that's gonna matter in this case, as his guys are so much more talented than ours. And Rashad White, who's not even really that good, breaks off a tackle and gains 15. Oh man, I don't know who that was that he beat, but that is not a fun start considering it's a lower level running back. We're not ready for this. We're not ready for anything. That tight end's gonna be so open. I don't know what the hell we're doing there. Russell Gage breaking off of a tackle as well to the 48-yard line. Two plays in a row now for 15 each. Don't really feel good about blitzing too often. And he's going to take that short to the outside as, wow, I thought he was going to break off that, but it was a good hit. Gains three. Could have been worse. It's not a bad thing to see. Holy crap, we got a lot of deep blues on one side of the field here. Brisker coming up, probably going to press the tight end. Nope, we're going to get beat. Oh, what a tackle attempt. Can we get him, though? Somebody help. Bringing the overload. How do I feel about it? Probably not great. Edwards on the inside. And he's in. Did our guy just leave him? Nice hit. Brisker with the recovery. Brisker was on him. I don't know if he was supposed to even be that DB. He was probably supposed to play the purple anyways. But he left him, and he's like, psych, I'm coming back. Don't worry about it. Kamara, the speed punter. Probably not going to do much with this anyways, but if we have any sort of chance. Good thing we have Mukuamu here, because that ball was literally perfect by him. And Velas Jones did not care. Run to the right. I would love to throw that back left, but I'm not going to. It's not bad, actually, as Herbert's going to get some yardage. I'm not even going to fight that. First down for 11. Just using that speed like we talked about with, you know, potentially starting Sean Tucker instead. You know, the way the blocks have lined up, you kind of just want speed. You don't even really... Oh! That's a really good play. Holds on, Cole Kmet for 13. The speed of Justin Fields. Every single person keeps getting us with their user linebacker up the middle, dude. It's so annoying. There goes wide open, and he misses it. Wow. Right, inside handoff. And we're going to bounce it as Herbert gains about 4 or 5. Sets us up for something here, you know? Want a quicker out for more. The tight end's probably our main look, but I don't really like that. Tanyan. That's a drop. That's going to be a punt. It's a tough miss from Fields, and ultimately can't recover from it. Will be a punt. Maybe could have ran it there and went for it on fourth. I don't know. Who the hell fakes special teams these days? Is that something that people do? He's got the fake set up. It's going to be a really good punt. Got to get over there. No! I think that was Terrell Smith running down there. He's not the slowest guy in the world either. Kyler Gordon looks like a run. Could be like an RPO. It's not bad by us. And of course, we're not going to hit it. How? How? How is Rashad White breaking every single tackle, dude? And we got our freebie too. And he's not going to get it out like we did. Because Kyle Trask, of course, does not have the same level of speed as Justin Fields does. Also, not running a lot of man coverage, which I think I probably should. Oh, that's a good run call. The run is just so deadly right now. Like, our run block sliders need to drop. Just the blocks are insane. Our D-line does suck, though, in fairness. I just left that wide open. If it's inside, he's going to have himself a play. And that will be a throwaway. Probably did have that underneath fullback or whatever, but it's okay. Pressure not getting there, though. Not that we have great pass rushers, but... So hoping to have something with that trade for Uche. Uche? Uche. Look at the blocks, dude. Good tackle by Gordon. 3rd and 4. Chance. Of course, that play makes a little more sense to be getting beat with the blocks because we kind of didn't really have many linebackers in on that play. This could be a tough jump on number 88, but if we could over-jump it. And he's going to take the hit. Good blitz. He kind of hesitated. He had a couple of guys that were open, but we were kind of near all of them, so... You can see why he hesitated just a sliver. But hey, good enough to stop him, and it will be a field goal, which will be up and good. But hey, the defense makes another stop, kind of. Velas Jones from deep in his own end zone. He's going to get himself a nice chance to the left, and he's going to break it free. Palmer's pretty fast, though. And Velas Jones is scoring from like 106. Not a bad play. Velas Jones for the touchdown. I know it's only 2 games, but we have already seen 2 kick-return touchdowns in each of the first starting weeks. He's like, screw it, I'll do it too. Why not? And not going to get nearly as close to the 21. All right, Eddie Jackson kind of helping over on the other side. I am not ready for that. And we actually tackle him one-on-one without help. Nice. We'll take it. Another man coverage look. Don't really have the speed on Godwin there, but... What can you do? Inside defense. Oh, is that me? No, it's not. What the hell was that? It almost worked. I wasn't ready for that. This is risky as hell. And it's an RPO right to the spot that I had to bait. The tackle attempts to the 36. Very Brisker to the middle of the field. Pretty good coverage. He's got a chance. And Trask hits that throw. Oh, my. He must be on the passing thingy. It's going to be a run. Get in there, Edmonds, please. Starting to slow down the run game a little bit, but it's still not perfect. Edmonds on the middle of the field. It's pretty good coverage. Oh, if it would have hit a little higher, we'd had a pick. The blitz actually get in there pretty quickly. The blitz has kind of worked. Base has been, like, useless. And he's going to take the coverage sack from Uche. Should be field goal range, but I don't know the wind, so he might have to punt it, and he will have to punt it. Finally back out on offense. Feels like it's been forever. Don't know how I feel about these audibles, so we're going to go inside with the trap. And we're going to find some room. A lot of room. Oh, I didn't see the other guy. I would have just kept running if I knew the other corner was going to come up. So far, you could definitely tell that the run blocking sliders need to come down a little bit, like we said. A little hard to tell on his side because his O-line is probably better at most spots than our D-line. And there goes Herbert into the pile. I mean, we lost him there for a second. We lost transmission. Mooney on the out. Slant from Moore. We'll see what we got. And there is nobody on him. His guy is backed up hard. Like, his guy was, like, all the way at, like, the 30 there by the time we hiked it. Play action does look really nice, but I also believe in this. I believe in the run. Damn, he didn't get the block. It's all right. DJ Moore got a good enough block. I'm going to hurry up to the line, actually. I really do like this play action, but I don't know if we're going to get anything on it. And that is overthrown. Damn, son! Up the middle. And Roschon Johnson, the big fella. Roschon making quick work of that one. Inside again. Oh, this time he's going to get us. Herbert falling forward, gets back to the line. Double coverage over there. I don't really know what I feel about this. The safety's not really there. I might just switch it to this traditional type play. Oh my. That was really close. I don't know how the hell he even came close to that throw. Of all the throws for him to get close on, that's the one. Okay. That should have never even had a chance. Good try, though. I'll give it to him. I appreciate when somebody does a really good throw, even though they probably shouldn't have had it. That's tough. Nah, that's a good pick. Damn, should have just played it safe. Neal's too big. 6'3". He's a problem. Kind of forced that one a little bit. Did have the pressure. Maybe need to try and move around with fields a little bit more. Obviously, this playbook only has that one read option. I'm still like trying to figure out what playbook I want to run. It's a really good tackle with Edmonds. We traced him and tracked him down really nicely there. Barely got him. That was close. Brisker coming in. Edwards kind of covering the out. Oh, that is wide open in the inside. Huge hit, but Trask with like no throw power is just fitting it in there with like all the time in the world. There's nobody on it. We're really struggling out here. Specifically on offense, to be fair. That's good. That's really good. We won the tap A button. Oh, we did a win. Edwards backing up. Brisker has been pretty good today. Oh, we got it. Nice. Good job, Brisker. Got the hands out there. No touching us. Holy crap. Tristan Wirfs is the fastest man alive. I don't know if he was just tired, but we barely got a piece of that, and he barely got a piece of us. That was a close one. I really like this play action, but I don't know if we're going to get that. I'm going to run it. Oh, we got some room. Herbert. Oh, my. Big hit. Neal scares me, dude. He's just a good player. I don't like him. Just know this. If you're a good player, I hate you, unless you're on our team. Then welcome to the team, buddy. Cole Kmet back at the end zone. Maybe a high point. Running back's wide open. Oh, nice move. He's going to be short to the one, though. Man, our pass game sucks, dude. It's so bad. Tough read on Mooney. How is that not a score? I don't understand what that, like, animation is. Like, why is that animation happening so often? Really don't want to be under center here. I didn't think it was an under center play, but it's a good block, and we will score. All right, Edwards. Oh, my Lord. I would love to see that back. Did you see that? Edwards slammed someone. I don't know who the hell it was, but I don't even know if they know who they are anymore. That was a hit and a half. Mukuhamu playing the deep safety spot. Running back's open. Oh, bad timing, I guess. Not really sure why that happened, but I've seen that before. Might just be a bad throw because he's a lower overall. I just haven't seen that in this game. Jones. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. That's a good cutback. Good tackle attempt, though. First down. Good screen. Just didn't see it. It was covering the other side. I'm actually going to go with Gordon just in case. And he's in some trouble. Uche with a sack again. The second one today. Finally seeing him work a little bit. He was going against a really bad tackle, though. So you would have thought it would have happened before this. Oh, get up there. And he holds on. Oh, my Lord. That is some luck. That was not a good read. Our guy is right on that and somehow doesn't pick it off. I'm actually shocked by that. I thought he was going to easily pick that. I mean, great coverage. Did what I could. I mean, what else could I do? I covered like two or three players there. 5 yards gain, but that's, I mean, about as good as you can get. Sewell, oh Lord. We're not even close to that play. We're actually pretty good here. He's going to take the running back. Goes possession. Good tackle. Two tap. I really don't like where Evans is on the field here. And he's going to take another sack. Is that Uche again? I'm going to call the timeout. Now, why did I do that? Why the hell did I just do that? That was a really bad decision. And I can't call a timeout to fix our play either. That's pretty good coverage, though. And dropped. Oof. That is a bit ridiculous that that was dropped. I ain't going to lie. Damn, I should have let the clock go, though. What is Gordon doing over here? Oh, we missed the hit. Yeah, that timeout has hurt us now, officially. Not as bad as the dropped interception, which was about as easy as you could get, does, but still. Mistake was by us in the first place. And that should be picked. Nice. I almost knocked it out, though. I almost had to pick, but the throw was so bad that Eddie had to get it. Good job. All right, up 14-3. Nothing we've really done on offense has caused this. Defense and special teams have us leading in this one. Velas Jones on the return. Already has one today. Oh, my Lord. All right, hurdled over a guy. That kind of sucked. Threw it at him a little violently. There's no need for that. Come on, Velas. You already got one. How many do you need? Is this Mooney on the deep? I'm still going to run it. And we're going to get about two. I felt like way more than two, though. There's a lot of like play action on this play. I don't really know how I feel about it. In this playbook, I should say. And he misses another one. Oh, my. Well, it would appear that I may need to change to the special passing mode. Because he cannot hit anything. That's brutal. I mean, he left that literally all user. Not, you know, he pulled him off. I don't know. That was like, he was like giving it to me. It was like I had a scenario with him and he wanted me to get it. What is this? This play looks all right. Right in behind the defense. Finally completing it. Getting slammed by Levante, but a first down's a first down. Play action on this is so hit or miss. We're going to try it. That's pretty good. No catch. Guy was all over him. All things considered, with how many misses Fields have had, has had today, I mean, that was a lot better than I was expecting. Really good blocks. I didn't hit it quick enough. I was kind of hesitant. I kind of thought we were just going to win. You know, I thought we were going to outrun them, but we didn't. Defense. Defense. There you go. And he drops it, of course. Of course. Of course. Cole Komet, the 6'6" guy with really high catching drops, but his guy on that deep play into triple, the number 3 or 4 wide receiver, holds on. My luck is very bad. Good kick, though, I suppose, up 14. All these missed throws, the dropped passes, it's brutal. Fields is not that bad to be missing the throws he's missing. Edwards got kind of a tough job here, really tough job. Nice hit, first down, though. I thought he was going to go inside. That's a little out there. I think the timing was more of the problem rather than the throw itself. There was just no room to put the ball in there at that point. Edwards in coverage against White. I'm sure this will go well. Oh, we get blocked off perfectly. Got a little bit of a blitz going. Good tackle. He tried to do something fancy with it this time and nowhere to go. Edmonds playing the hook over on the other side. And he's going to take the coverage sack, kind of. Rashad White injured on the blocking, I think, of the play. I don't know what to run here, because I don't want to just, like, back everyone up, and then he gets in behind, because he has all day to throw. Who's the one blitzing? Edwards. Interesting. Kyler Gordon going against Godwin. I don't know what kind of route this is going to be. And that should be picked. Drop. That's all right. It sucks. We'd have better field position, but it's okay. Abdominal tear, almost said strain, for his starting running back, who's actually killed it this game. See what Tyler Scott's got. Oh, I did not think that was a sit down. I think it may have, to be honest, been an option play. I thought he was going to go all the way, though. This looks good for Tyler Scott. I don't know about anyone else, though. And he's open. Finally hitting the throw, and Mooney. No, that's not Mooney. That's Tyler Scott. Trying to outrun everyone to the 25-yard line. Beautiful throw. Great catch and everything. Perfect play. Finally hitting a play that's not like, dude, this would be really bad. I'm going to actually slant more. I don't think they can cover him across the field. Yeah, I'm not going to get that. I tried to stop and couldn't get there. Don't know what DJ Moore's doing, but apparently not winning his route is the answer there. What are these plays, though? They just want us to be like really conservative, I guess, which makes sense because we're winning by 14. A field goal wins the game, but I'm trying to develop our game for next week. You know, I'm worried about next week, if anything. You know, this is a Buccaneers team that is pretty depleted on, I mean, some of the most important positions. That's not really that open, but it's open enough, and he will get it for the first down. I mean, I took a lot of shots in this game. I tried as much as I could, and Fields just missed like 90% of them. And that's going to be picked. Terrible decision. I don't know why I threw that. Felt bad about going too short, and then what happens? You throw a stupid wild interception. He was kind of open. It's just, it's hard to throw into coverage, dude. There's, like, always someone there. Unless you're us. We have nobody anywhere, ever. And we tried. Good tackle. Gains 9, though. Ooh, you want to force the ball into coverage, buddy, when you need a field goal for the win? Sure. Oh, nice slam, though. Brisker killing him. Edmonds. Running back's open. Not going to take it, though. Surprised the game didn't think that was PI when the ball was already out. Like, tackled the hell out of him. But obviously, that was uncatchable. Brisker pretending to cover the run, but I don't know if it's actually going to be one. Good tackle. Brisker with the pop. This is an interesting play now. Oh, nice hit. Teamwork. No matter who your receiver is, there's a good chance that if he's in, you know, coverage like that, he's going to get blasted when there's guys all over it. He's probably going to get blasted. Bayless Jones, who has a kick return touchdown, going try and get the punt return touchdown as he's looking pretty good to do so. Not going to get out there. That juke move was way too harsh. Still a decent return, though. Yeah, this play's all right. See how he wants to cover it, though. Running back is wide open. Be to the fourth quarter. This play looks kind of interesting. I think we had this open with DJ Moore last game. But he missed the throw. This time he doesn't, and it's on the money. DJ Moore's going to score. Huge play and probably the dagger. Finally. Finally hitting a big-time throw, Fields. That play's pretty good. I don't know what it is about it. I don't know if he had any safeties up or back, I suppose. Good defense. Special teams, if you want to call it. Which, if you want to, that's because you're correct. And that's what it's called. Eddie! There's a bunch of buttons on this. Is that something you could do? Try to help hit. I think we did. Don't even know. Didn't really run with Fields this much, or in this game much. I need to find a playbook with, like, decent read option stuff. Because we tried it in this game, and obviously it wasn't great. And that could be picked. Pick for Eddie Jackson again. And, of course, there's Mike Evans. Eddie Jackson maybe making a case for him to get himself a breakout. I don't know if they do that for really old players or not. Sorry, Eddie, didn't need to crap on you like that. And Roshan's finding some room. Slow man. Stiff arm attempt to the 33. Herbert, tons of room here. That was a pretty stupid move as that took so much out. And now Darnell Wright, our starting right tackle, is injured. Going to run it again. And gets blasted by Shaquille. Thankfully, he's not injured long term. We'll have to start the backup just for now. This play last time didn't work for us, and the fact that his guys are kind of on that tells me it's not going to be great again. What is that? Okay, I mean, I guess it works. Did not intend that at all. I guess you could run with Fields in that situation? I don't even know. This game actually was pretty close for a while, and then our defense just kept the pressure up, didn't let him move at all, and we finally moved the ball a little bit on offense ourselves. you'd think you would use Baker. Like, I get, like, you don't want to start an older quarterback, but, like, Kyle Trask ain't the guy anyways either, so at least with Baker, you have a chance to win some games. I don't know. You never know. Baker's okay enough. He's probably got some okay passer passing stuff, stats. Speaking of Baker, there goes Eddie for number three. Wow, that was not... it was pretty bad timing for me to talk about maybe put Baker in. Then again, he just went for it. He, at this point, doesn't really have that much to lose. Up the middle for Roshan. Oh, there's a hold. Nice power play, but, I mean, really didn't gain much anyways. Fields deserves to get injured on this read option, I'll be honest with you, but we're still going to run it. And on the major blitz, Khalil Herbert has room. Nice move inside. Khalil Herbert going to go down because it would be stat padding. If not, it's still probably almost stat padding just running down that far. All hail Eddie Jackson. If that ain't a player of the week, that is harsh. Obviously, a lot of people might get like a pick six or something like that. And two interceptions of the pick six probably wins it. Is that really a penalty? Oh, no. Was that Uche as well? No, that's so BS. He ran into me. That's not... Okay. It's not my fault. And he's going to go for the shot again. And it's going to be dropped. Number 9 versus number 3. That's 12. I'm actually going to use this. Oh, that's good. Doesn't bring him down. Oh, Edmonds will. Man, Edmonds is a scary dude. Like, he is so huge. He's like 6'5", 250. He's ridiculous. I'd be scared. Uche not going to get there. He's actually got room to run. Baker on the run. Hit him late. Uche user is actually not bad, but obviously we're going against a pretty bad right tackle. Not even really a right tackle, to be honest. Gonna take the shot. And it's good defense by Tyreek Stevenson. I suppose when you figure you don't really care about your actual, you know, quarterbacks that you got, trying to jump ball, trying to get some stats for the receivers that are developing isn't the worst thing in the world to try. That's a little bit of a late read. Still probably gets it there if Baker isn't a bot, but Baker's a bot. I lied. He should just use Trask. Or probably trade for someone. There's got to be a QB around here somewhere. Where are you, Mr. QB? We know you're around here. Nah, I can't catch. Oh, that's good coverage, actually. And in some trouble. I'd even go for the pick, and our guy does. Everything's a broken tackle. It's so brutal. Obviously, the size difference between the tight end and the cornerback does exist. Kate Otten injured on that play. He got hit really hard to the knee. He's now down to that freaking fullback-looking tight end that's always given me troubles in the past. Watch, he's actually going to get a touchdown with him this drive. I know it. Didn't get off the block. He runs right into us. Not going to get him, apparently. Edmonds tackled for a gain of 5. Foot fracture. He did get hit in the leg. That's a freaking injury. And that could be picked. And it is! Eddie! No, is that? Yeah, it is! 4 picks for Eddie Jackson! I think I'm supposed to have the starters out, actually. Whoops. Like, I'm just not, as the Bears, expecting to have, like... Ah, crap. I'm just not expecting to be up by this much, really, to be honest. Like, I'm just in full mode of, like, normal gameplay, like last week, where we just barely scraped together a lucky win because of missed throws. Oh, my Roshan. The trucking. Oh, my word! Diving interception by Kyler Gordon. Oh, my. That is something. All right, this final score is 34-3 over the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Not a scoreline I was expecting to see at all this season, but I suppose the Buccaneers would be a roster that I would kind of think would be on that list. Fields wasn't great, but ended up picking up a couple of stats near the end of the game that made it look a little better, at least. Herbert was great, but like I said, think he's going to be benched. Probably going to be benched because I accidentally ran him while we were already up by more than 3 possessions. So I think it's going to be Roshan Johnson slash Sean Tucker time next week for a game. And as far as receiving goes, Mooney didn't really have much. Who even had much? It was a big play to Moore. Tyler Scott had a big play too. But outside of that, really didn't have much going for ourselves. Sack totals, 2.5 for Uche. Could develop a breakout. Jalen Jones, maybe. Kyler Gordon had a pick. I mean, I don't know if old players can get a dev up, but Eddie Jackson deserves one with 4 interceptions in one game. Cole Kmet with an upgrade. He's now an 80 overall. I don't know what's the best way to get vertical threat, but you would, or a speed upgrade, but you would assume it'd be vertical threat. I almost never see them, though. Short route +3, deep route +2, release and catch in traffic +1. That's a really nice upgrade, even +2 to stiff arm, which is now 72, which is pretty cool. Very good short route runner, I suppose. And of course, Velus Jones with the kick return touchdown. Deep threat is the best way to get him, like, speed upgrades. His best role on this team is kick returner, so the faster he gets, the better it is. A speed upgrade now, put him at 95. Jarvon Dexter, he needs so much work, but obviously getting to the quarterback, getting sacks is the best way to get your overall higher, so going to go with power move, which, once again, he is so raw. DT is probably our biggest need right now. We just have nothing going on there. And we did win the game, though. GG to Mike. He played a valiant effort. You know, it's a tough one with those quarterbacks. And our defense was actually kind of cooking. And more importantly, we have played this game quite a bit so far. Not that I'm saying I'm good at the game, but, you know, I'm got a feel for it now already. And in general, those quarterbacks, so unusable for Tampa. It's a bottom five roster, technically. I know they got a couple of pieces, but a lot of those guys are kind of aging. Like, Barrett's going to be gone soon. Levante is going to be gone soon. Jensen might even retire after this season. In real life, he definitely will. We're allowing him to play in here because, you know, this is technically before the season started, even preseason. So everything that's fair is fair. And it's more fun to just play with all the players you have anyways. And yeah, I mean, we'll see what happens with him in the future. You know, on par for a decent draft pick at least. And yeah, we have the Chiefs next game, which I'm sure is going to be so much fun. Playing against Mahomes and company, that will probably be our first loss of the season. But anyways, if you guys enjoy this one, maybe leave a like, subscribe if you're new. Follow me on Twitter, Jeromepkr, second channel, PKR Plays for non-Madden content. And that probably be it. I might have even set a very unrealistic like goal on the first video just because I kind of need the break in between these episodes. So I guess maybe I would say, 1,000 likes and we'll do episode 3 tomorrow because, like I said, I kind of need you not to hit the like goal, but I would definitely appreciate the likes. So that's about it. Thanks for watching. I'll let you guys come back for next video. But until next video, where Khalil Herbert's probably benched, see ya!